Tuesday the 10th of January on the Radio 1 Breakfast Show. Good morning, 7:30. Greg James with you till 10:30 today. And let's get you a news update. Everything you need to know. Here comes Callum Leslie with the latest.
Radio 1. News Beat.
Talk about that January feeling. That's what space experts in Cornwall will likely have this morning after the first ever satellite launch in the UK flopped pretty badly.
And that producer also worked with Little Sims. So if you hear it and think, that sounds very familiar. Because production, that's why. I want to be on a beach. Sorry. I do. All right, on the other side, some rain and mist. Let's do 7:30 Newsbeat.
One extra Newsbeat.
Talk about that January feeling. That's what space experts in Cornwall will likely have this morning after the first ever satellite launch in the UK flopped pretty badly.
That's on the way. And also, our Richie gives No Lyrics Karaoke TikTok sensation a little try at 7:10. Should be interesting. No cocktails involved. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 7 o'clock on Tuesday the 10th of January. Good morning, this is Claire Runacres. Ministers will bring controversial anti-strike legislation before Parliament today. In Scotland, teachers at state schools are beginning 2 days of strike action, and the first mission to launch satellites into space from British soil has ended in failure. The government will introduce a law in Parliament today which will force striking public sector workers to provide a minimum level of service.
Oh, brilliant DIY, Paul Heaton and Jackie Abbott on the way then. Your space songs on the 7:33. Claire has your headlines now. On to
BBC News, this is Claire Runacres. The government will introduce a law in Parliament today which will force striking public sector workers to provide a minimum level of service.
In Alas, he is unable to travel to Liverpool, but Vikingo will be a fine replacement. This is BBC Radio 3 at 7 o'clock on Tuesday the 10th of January. The news summary from Paul Ginnery.
The first mission to launch satellites into space from British soil has ended in failure.
In the next hour on this programme, how do you talk to children? How do we talk to our children about the self-proclaimed misogynist Andrew Tate? We'll also be celebrating the life of Gareth Bale, the career of Gareth Bale, who's announced his retirement.
You're listening to Today on BBC Radio 4. It's 7 o'clock on Tuesday, the 10th of January. The headlines this morning. The government will introduce legislation today to force striking workers to provide minimum safety levels in key public services. Thousands of people have taken to the streets of Brazil to protest against the storming of government buildings by a far-right mob. Prince Harry's widely trailed memoir has gone on sale in the UK. And an attempt to make British space history by launching satellites from UK soil has ended in failure. The BBC News is read by Alan Smith.
The government will introduce a law in Parliament today forcing some public sector workers to provide a minimum level of service, even if they go on strike.
And the weather will be cloudy, wet and windy today. A band of heavy rain moving northeastwards across the UK. It will turn drier for a time in the south.
You're listening to Today on Radio 4 with Michelle Hussain and Justin Webb. The time is 28 minutes to 8. Alan Smith has a summary of the news.
A new law is being introduced in Parliament today which will force striking public sector workers to provide a minimal level of service.
I mean, like I said before, you've got to look at this as a long-term issue. The 19% pay increase is recompense for a decade of degradation. Nurses are chronically underpaid.
So, okay, got you. So your argument is take the long-term view backwards. Thank you very much indeed. Takes us right back to where we started, doesn't it? Mrs. Thatcher, perhaps, some people argue. This is an interesting one. Quite a few people have said this. If politicians expect a minimum service level from the public services, then that principle should apply to politicians. Minimum attendance levels for peers and MPs and the removal of long-term summer and winter recesses. As from Andy in Leicester, Lord Andy from Leicester, that's his suggestion. Gareth Bale, best of British, what do you reckon? Tell me what you think.
The voice of the UK. This is BBC Radio 5 Live.
We're the BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Jason Kay. The Westminster government will introduce new legislation in Parliament today, which will ensure a minimum level of service during strikes by most public sector workers.
I mean, mind you, if you're a member of staff, you can have a cheeky read in the story.
Oh, for sure. Yeah. That for sure.
James, I'm a big reader. I love that it's the power of books. Whatever's in the covers, it's getting people reading, I guess, which is one thing to celebrate. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks very much.
James Daunt there, the chief executive of Waterstones.
Yeah, listen, when have you been on your own as that woman was at Waterstones in Piccadilly queuing for Harry's book? Some great stories. Mark in Leeds. Saw the film Sin City in an empty multiplex. When I needed a wee, I shouted to the projection hole, "Can you pause it for a minute? I need the loo." This is when I realised the projector was fully automated. Darn it. Stories like that. When have you been in a party of one? You've ended up on your own. Exercise classes, lots of those coming in. Do text us 85058. You can send us a voice note as well. 08085 909 693.
Live Drive. Claire McDonnell and Tony Livesey.
Let's have a look at the news headlines then this afternoon on Drive. The Business Secretary, Grant Shapps, has set out a draft law to guarantee minimum levels of service during public sector strikes. The legislation would cover six areas: health, education, transport, fire and rescue, border security and nuclear decommissioning.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you. Professor Anthony King, Chair of War Studies at the University of Warwick. Right, it's Drive with Tony and Claire. It's 5:30. Let's get the news and sport.
Listen on BBC Sounds. This is BBC Radio 5 Live.
Here are the headlines. The government has outlined draft legislation to ensure a minimum level of service during public sector strikes.
First new album in 24 years is coming out, and we have got the first taste of it for you on this show. So don't go anywhere. It's 8:30 on 6 Music, and time for the news.
6 Music. BBC Radio 6 Music.
And we're the BBC News. I'm Jason Kay. Good morning to you. The government will introduce a new law in Parliament today forcing workers in transport, health and some other public services to provide a minimum level of service during strikes.
Jal, Dr. Zeus and Rahat Fateh Ali Khan. Still got music on the way from DA, some Diljit Dosanjh as well as some Shilpa Rao, and we're going to be restarting our Horn Club just after Newsbeat Now with Callum Leslie.
Newsbeat.
Talk about that January feeling. That's what space experts in Cornwall will likely have this morning after the first ever satellite launch in the UK flopped pretty badly.
Andy Burrows there, who's been inspired by Doddy Weir. It is almost 7 o'clock.
On FM,
digital radio,
and on BBC Sounds.
This is BBC Radio Wales.
Good morning. Welcome. 7 o'clock, Tuesday, the 10th of January. You're listening to BBC Radio Wales Breakfast with me, Claire Summers. Wales's Health Minister, Eluned Morgan, will give a statement later today on the latest NHS winter pressures. And what next for Gareth Bale? We will look back at the enormous impact he's had in a red shirt with Wales manager Rob Page. That's on the way. First, though, Tom is here with everything you need to know this morning.
Thank you, Claire Borodar. The Health Minister will deliver a statement today on the pressures facing the Welsh NHS.
It's only been out for about 7 hours.
Well, you never know, give 7 hours. Listen, Philip, good to talk to you. Thank you very much for coming on. Philip Jones there, editor of the Bookseller magazine. Of course, Kensington Palace and Buckingham Palace have both said they will not comment on the contents of the book. It's 7:30. Good morning. If you are just joining us, let's bring you up to date. Here's Tom.
Thank you, Claire. The Health Minister will be questioned by Senedd members for the first time this year about the winter crisis in the NHS.
Diolch yn fawr iawn.
Mae'n wleidyddiaeth a mae'n wleidyddiaeth rygbi.
Yeah.
A gallu bobl penderfynu beth yw'r un sydd mwy o gorfforol.
Gen i weld, diolch yn fawr iawn am fygyda ni, edrych yn fawr i weld y rhaglen yma, y gêm yn y gwaed, Rygbi Cymru a Carwyn Jones yn cyflwyno. Na ddim alwfen gyn frifyn.
Na, dwi'n mynd i gofio'r dyfyniad yna, mae'n awleidyddiaeth a mae'n awleidyddiaeth rygbi. Defnyddiol iawn at y dyfodol.
Digidol, BBC Sounds, Seinydd Clyfar ac ar FM.
Dyma BBC Radio Cymru.
Mae'n 8 o'r gloch chi'n gwrando ar Dros Frecwas gyda Dylan Ebenez ar y fenne Kate Crockett.
A dyma'r prif benawdau disgwyl i'r gwneudog iechyd yr Uned Morgan ei datganiad ynglyn â'r pwysau presennol ar y gwasanaeth iechyd. Yr ymgais gyntaf, lansiollio'i rennau i'r gofod o'r Deyrnas Unedig wedi methu. Cynlluniau wedi coeddi greu canolfan feddygaeth niwclear yn Rhawsfynydd a Viva Gareth Bale. Mwy o ymateb i'r newyddion bod arwr Peildroed Cymru wedi ymddeol. Y bwletin gan ni nesa gyda Ifan Owain.
Mae disgwyli'r gweinidog iechyd Dylaned Morgan wneud datganiad yn y Senedd nes ymlaen ynglyn â'r pwysau presennol ar y gwasanaeth iechyd.
Gyda ni, Llyraf Gareth, gyda ni pennaeth Policy Federation y Busnesau Bach yng Nghymru.
Ar Radio Digidol, BBC Sounds, Seinydd Clyfar ac ar FM.
Dyma BBC Radio Cymru.
Dewch chi'n edrych ar raglygon y tywydd nesa, dalwch mlaen yn dyn. Chi'n barod amdani, bore diflas a glib. Mi fydd yna law trwm a gwyntoedd cryf i'r mwyafrif, peth cyntaf bore yma.
Wedyn ni bod ti wedi bod yn noson blasigyn, neithwr hefyd. Da iawn, dwliar hwnna. Chi'n gwrando'r bore cothi, cadwch gwmni ni. Ni'n mynd i drafod planhigion a therfedd i fi gael y treigliad iawn. Yn ystod yr awr nesa, o, mae yna limbrig fach hwyr wedi cyrraedd. Gewn ni ddarllen hwnna hefyd ar ôl y bwletin newyddion. Ond arosswch gyda ni, mae'n tynnu at hanner dydd nawr draw yn i'r stafell newyddion at ni at ydyr.
Diolch Sian a phnawn da i chi gyd. Yn ôl Gweinidog Iechyd Cymru, fe gafodd cynlluniau'r Llywodraeth i ddelio phwysau'r gaeaf ar wasanaethau i llethu gan gynnydd sydyn mewn feirysau.
Ta beth, elef system a ffreud i ffil. Ond nawr, dyma'r newyddion am 8 o'r gloch gyda Ifan Owain.
Mae disgwyli'r gweinidog iechyd Dylaned Morgan wneud datganiad yn y Senedd nes ymlaen ynglyn â'r pwysau presennol ar y gwasanaeth iechyd.
8.295 on the text, hashtag BBCGMS. The time now, 7 o'clock.
On digital radio.
FM.
Your smart speaker.
And on BBC Sounds.
BBC Radio Scotland.
Hello, good morning. As Martin says, it is 7 o'clock and it's also Tuesday the 10th of January. This is Good Morning Scotland with Lucy White.
And Martin Geisler. Primary schools across Scotland will be closed today as teachers walk out in a dispute over pay.
Coming up, Scotland's Health Secretary Humza Yousaf will set out plans later on how to ease the pressure on the NHS this winter.
And we'll speak to the Glasgow man who saved a child who was thrown to him from a burning building.
Fascinating story that's coming up just before 8 o'clock this morning. First of all, the very latest BBC News. Virtually all primary schools will be closed today because of another teacher strike. That's good to hear, isn't it, Phil? Thank you very much. Phil's back in an hour. The time is 7:30.
A summary of the news. Primary schools across the country won't be opening their doors this morning as teachers walk out in another round of strikes.
7:30.
Good morning on this Tuesday the 10th of January. You're listening to Around Orkney from the BBC with Hannah Rowe.
And with me, Helen Fowle. It's a very good morning coming up on the programme. We'll hear from the outgoing chair of the NFU in Orkney about his two-year term and his predictions for this year's firming in the county.
And on a very special anniversary for the Society of Beef Shorthorn Cattle, we'll hear why the breed is so successful in Orkney.
Shorthorn cattle are suited to Orkney. They're hardy. They've always worked here along with the Angus. There's more shorthorns in the field than there's more at the show, which is fantastic to see.
And getting the nutrition right for your yows ahead of lambing.
Just saving a kind of couple of hundred grams if you've got better forage in terms of your concentrate intake. I mean, pence can add up to pounds quite fast, so it can save you a lot of money on farm while also optimising efficiency and reducing waste.
A lot and much more to come. First, Hannah has the news.
Almost all primary schools in the county will be shut today after talks between the Scottish Government and the teaching unions failed to agree a pay deal.
And this debate go next.
Well,
Hello and welcome to Good Evening Shetland. Iona Nicol and Eva Runciman with you until 6.
In the news tonight, all secondary schools in the Isles will be closed tomorrow in the second day of strike action by teachers.
Coming up in the programme, there are concerns from tourist operators over the delay in opening up summer bookings on the North boats.
It will affect anybody going on holiday, can't book the boat at all.
There are concerns about the new government scheme to help businesses with their energy costs.
Really, the new support is totally insufficient for energy-hungry businesses like those in food and drink processing, tourism and hospitality, manufacturing and so on. Indeed, all businesses are hit by it.
We hear from Northern Isles MP Alistair Carmichael as he looks ahead to 2023, including costs of living pressures.
Rather than just treating the symptoms, we've got to get to the underlying cause of the disease.
And we hear about plans to boost table tennis numbers in the Isles. Then at 6, Barbara Sheen is with us for Him About and Farther. But before all that, here's Eva with the news.
Thanks, Iona. All secondary schools across the Isles will be closed tomorrow in the second day of strike action by teachers.
BBC Radio Nigel, Martin Vagave, Shaw, Adishtamat Ninshu, let Don Motherstan, Ugs Innisroch.
Martin Va, Nipti of Nayakin, Ha Dalla, the Stalkin look Chekish Katoshagan, and Nalapa and you, Nepun Scotian and you, Ugs Naharst Scotian Amarach.
BBC News NI. On Radio Ulster and on BBC Sounds.
It's 3 o'clock, I'm Gráinne Conley. A gang of masked men armed with a crowbar, sledgehammers and baseball bats have assaulted three people in Ballymoney.
On BBC Sounds, your radio, TV and smart speaker, this is BBC Radio 4.
BBC Radio 4 News at 3 o'clock with Anna Maguire. A number of people, including a child, have escaped injury after shots were fired at a house in Derry.
Give me your favourite and most hated tube station on the entire underground. We've had two votes already for Bank being the worst. So unless someone offers something else, I'm going to make it official. But before we do anything else, Mike Duran's got the latest news.
From the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker,
play BBC Radio London,
and on your radio,
the sound of London is BBC Radio London.
At 8 with the latest for London, I'm Mike Duran. The government is bringing in legislation today to ensure minimum safety levels during industrial action on the basis that life and limb must come first when strike action takes place.
If they are relating to trains, underground or the name of underground stations, 81333 on the text message. Start your message with the word London. Just after the news, very special guest Giles Brandreth will be joining me. But let's get the latest from Mike Duran first before anything else.
With the latest for London, I'm Mike Duran. A new law to be brought in today will force public sector workers to ensure vital public services maintain a basic function when workers go on strike.
This is the BBC World Service, the world's radio station.
Hello and welcome to Newsday on the BBC World Service with Rob Young and Sana Safi.
There's been condemnation from around the world after protesters stormed Brazil's congressional building. Supporters of the far-right former president Jair Bolsonaro attacked federal buildings across the capital as they demanded the recently elected president Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva stand down.
US President Joe Biden has visited the Texas border town of El Paso as he looks to try and seize the initiative on the migration crisis there. He's now headed to Mexico City for a summit with his Canadian and Mexican counterparts.
As China loosens travel restrictions, there are concerns about COVID cases accelerating within the country. Near neighbour South Korea is implementing new border controls.
And we'll have all the sport, but first, the news.
Hello, I'm Neil Nunes with the BBC News. The Brazilian President Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva has visited Congress and other government buildings in Brasilia hours after they were ransacked by supporters of the far-right former President Jair Bolsonaro.
Sounds of the City with Peter White continues Wednesday at 9:30 and 20 GMT.
Hello, you're with Newsday from the BBC World Service with Rob Young and Sana Safi.
We look at Namibia's Baby Savers Initiative, where under pressure mothers can give up their babies to the authorities anonymously.
Journalism is further under threat in Belarus. High-profile journalists go on trial there today.
And we hear the latest from Prince Harry and more revelations from his upcoming memoir.
But first, a summary of the latest world news.
BBC News with Neil Nunes. The Brazilian President Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva has inspected the damage inflicted on Congress after it was ransacked by supporters of his predecessor, Jair Bolsonaro.
British Gas. Here to solve. Subject to eligibility.
On the free Absolute Radio app, on digital radio, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute Radio.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
British Gas. Here to solve. Subject to eligibility.
On the free Absolute Radio app for mobile and tablet, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute Radio 60s.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
British Gas. Here to solve. Subject to eligibility.
On the free Absolute Radio app, on digital radio in London, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute Radio 70s.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
British Gas. Here to solve. Subject to eligibility.
On the free Absolute Radio app, on digital radio, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute 80s.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
British Gas. Here to solve. Subject to eligibility.
On the free Absolute Radio app, on digital radio, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute Radio 90s.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
British Gas. Here to solve. Subject to eligibility.
On the free Absolute Radio app, on digital radio in London, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute Radio Noughties.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
British Gas. Here to solve. Subject to eligibility.
On the free Absolute Radio app, on digital radio in London, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute Radio 10s.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
Where new music matters. This is Absolute Radio 20s.
On the free Absolute Radio app for mobile and tablet, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute Radio 20s.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
British Gas. Here to solve. Subject to eligibility.
On the free Absolute Radio app, on digital radio, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute Classic Rock.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
British Gas. Here to solve. Subject to eligibility.
On the free Absolute Radio app, on digital radio, or ask your smart speaker to play Absolute Radio Country.
I'm Kat Wright. A group representing medics is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
Book now with Virgin Atlantic. See the world differently.
Ask your smart speaker to play Cool FM.
Northern Ireland's number one for music.
It's 8 o'clock, I'm Chloe St. John. First this morning, some new advice as winter illnesses continue to spread.
Ridiculous, well, you wouldn't do that.
Easier than going up the morn saying LeBron.
A valid point, actually.
Bright spells and a few showers, breezy too, and highs of 11. This is the home of the Cool FM Downtown Cash Call with over 20 grand up for grabs this week. If you want to win it, stay here for all the info. And kids, Cool Before School is back. If you want to be on, we'd love to hear from you. Pick up the phone, 0891 820010. Palos in sport, Bexy's in travel, and Chloe's got your latest news headlines.
Good morning. Coming up, the Public Health Agency says flu and other respiratory illnesses are likely to increase in the coming weeks.
Book now with Virgin Atlantic. See the world differently.
On your radio, on the Downtown Radio app, and ask your smart speaker to play Downtown Radio.
It's 8 o'clock, I'm Chloe St. John. First this morning, some new advice as winter illnesses continue to spread. Crazy
what love can do. Tim McKenna, Becky Hill, Ella Henderson and Crazy What Love Can Do. Good morning, the time now, 8.33. Let's get you the very latest sport. That's coming up with Palo Glenn's taking a look at the traffic and travel for you. And Chloe has the headlines. Good morning.
Good morning. Coming up, the Public Health Agency says flu and other respiratory illnesses are likely to increase in the coming weeks.
Book now with Virgin Atlantic. See the world differently.
On digital, online and on your smartphone. Downtown Country.
It's 8 o'clock, I'm Chloe St. John. First this morning, some new advice as winter illnesses continue to spread.
Call me, send me your answer from our Facebook page or drop me an email. Let me know what local series used that TV theme. News headlines with Chloe next.
Good morning. Coming up, the Public Health Agency says flu and other respiratory illnesses are likely to increase in the coming weeks.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
Good morning, it's 4th 1, it's the 4th of January, Wednesday morning, boogie in the morning. Let's get the news, 7 o'clock. Here's Max Steele with the update.
Across Edinburgh, the Lothians and Fife. Play 4th 1.
Leading doctors say no option should be off the table in tackling the pressure on Scotland's NHS.
What's your best bit of trivia? Hit us up, 0131 557 4000 is the number.
This is 4th 1.
Max has the news.
Leading doctors say no option should be off the table when it comes to tackling the pressure on Scotland's NHS.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
Play
4th 2.
On digital radio, on the app, online, and on your smart speaker.
The greatest hits for Edinburgh, the Lothians, and Fife.
4th 2.
Leading doctors say no option should be off the table in tackling the pressure on Scotland's NHS.
Tell you all about that in a couple of minutes, but your weather, light rain throughout the day, unfortunately, all over the place, and highs of 9, 7.30. Let's get your latest news headlines.
Leading doctors say no option should be off the table when it comes to tackling the pressure on Scotland's NHS.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
Play
Greatest Hits Radio.
On digital radio, Freeview 716, Sky 0151, online and on your smart speaker across the UK.
This is Greatest Hits Radio.
The Prime Minister's set to announce new plans that will see all pupils in England study maths until they're 18.
And get ready for the Bluebells and Steve Harley. It is 7:30 exactly on a Wednesday morning. It's time now for your headlines.
The Prime Minister's set to announce a new plan that will see all pupils in England study maths until they're 18.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
Online, on your phone, on your smart speaker, this is Heat Radio.
The latest this hour, the Prime Minister's set to announce new plans that will see all pupils in England study maths until they're 18.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On the way, tunes from Alice DJ and Pink. But right now, it's 7 o'clock. Let's get the latest.
Across the UK.
Play Hits Radio.
The Prime Minister is set to announce new plans that will see all pupils in England study maths until they're 18.
Coming up, tunes from Elton John and Dermot Kennedy. But right now, let's get the latest.
I love you.
7:30.
This is
Hits Radio.
The Prime Minister is set to announce a new plan that will see all pupils in England study maths until they're 18.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
Online, on app, on digital radio, and on your smart speaker. Playing the world's greatest jazz, soul, and blues. This is the UK's Jazz FM.
Good morning, it's 7 o'clock on Wednesday the 4th of January. You're listening to Jazz FM Breakfast with Nigel Williams. The news is read by Liam Arrowsmith.
The Prime Minister's set to announce new plans that will see all pupils in England study maths until they're 18.
From the soundtrack of Ma Rainey's Black Bottom, the multi-Grammy, multi-award-winning movie, and it's 7:30. This is Jazz FM Breakfast with Nigel Williams. The headlines. The Prime Minister is planning to announce that pupils in England will study mathematics until they're 18.
Book now with Virgin Atlantic. See the world differently.
Nationwide on Freeview, on your mobile, on your smart speaker, and at kerrangradio.co.uk.
This is Kerrang Radio.
The latest this hour, the Prime Minister says he wants all pupils in England to study maths until they're 18.
We're about to get into that, but before we do, just before 8, let's get the latest KISS news with Aileen.
KISS, all students in England could soon be studying some form of maths till they're 18.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On FM.
On digital radio.
On your mobile and here.
Play Lynx FM.
Across Lincolnshire and Newark. Lynx FM.
Hospitals across both Lincolnshire and Northern Lincolnshire are seeing a huge rise in the number of people going to A&E.
I should just fess up, really, shouldn't I? 6:30, weather today, very mild if you're just stepping out of the house at the moment. Temperatures into double figures right now, but very breezy, as it will be right through the day. Some sunny spells breaking through the cloud, though, and tops about 12 degrees. Let's get the latest now, 6:30 for your Wednesday, with Andy Marsh.
Across Lincolnshire and Newark, Lynx FM News.
Hospitals in both Lincolnshire and Northern Lincolnshire are seeing a huge rise in the number of people going to A&E.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
One of the greatest movie songs of all time after the news, and a reminder of how 20 grand can be yours.
All of the songs you love, magic.
On digital radio, on the Magic Radio app, online and on your smart speaker.
Play Magic Radio.
The top stories this morning. All pupils in England will study some form of maths until they're 18 under a new plan from Rishi Sunak.
Holland and Barrett. Wellness that's worth it.
See our website for T's and C's. Products contain Vit C contributing to normal immune system function.
On digital radio, on the Magic Radio app, online and on your smart speaker. This is Magic Chilled.
The top stories this morning. All pupils in England could soon be studying maths until they're 18 as part of plans by Rishi Sunak to tackle poor numeracy skills.
A Man Called Otto, only in cinemas from January 6.
Across the UK on DAB Digital Radio, online at mellowmagic.co.uk, on the free Magic Radio app and on your smart speaker.
Play Mellow Magic.
The top stories at 7 o'clock. Good morning, I'm Fran Godfrey. The Health Secretary has insisted flu, COVID-19 and strep A are to blame for pressures on the NHS over Christmas.
Search Benson's for beds. Sleep made better. Terms and conditions apply. 29.8% representative APR. Credit subject to status. Benson's are a credit broker, not a lender. Exclusions and minimum spend apply.
Playing Stevie, Aretha and Marvin and the best of Soul and Motown.
On digital radio, on your mobile and at magic.co.uk. This is Magic Soul.
All pupils in England could soon be studying maths until they're 18 as part of plans by Rishi Sunak to tackle poor numeracy skills.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On FM.
On digital radio.
On your mobile and here.
Play Pirate FM.
This is the station that loves Cornwall. Pirate FM.
Cornwall's NHS has faced extreme pressures over the holidays after a critical incident was declared for the duchy last month.
You can call us 01209 313 900. That's also the WhatsApp number you need, or you can text us on 63103 and start that message off with the word pirate.
Right, 7:31 with the news headlines for Cornwall. Here's Sophie.
Cornwall's NHS is describing their Christmas in winter as challenging as they remain in the highest alert level at Opal 4.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
From the four corners of our planet, Planet Rock News.
The latest this hour, the Prime Minister's set to announce new plans that will see all pupils in England study maths until they're 18.
Book now with Virgin Atlantic. See the world differently.
Across the UK on DAB Digital Radio,
on the app,
at scalaradio.co.uk,
and on your smart speaker.
This is Scala Radio News.
The latest this hour, the Prime Minister says he wants all pupils in England to study maths until they're 18.
64100, the text number, starting your message with the word Scala. Email charles at scalaradio.co.uk. We'll sort that out this side of eight. Headlines at 7:30. The Prime Minister is planning to announce an ambition for all pupils in England to study maths until they're 18.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On FM, digital radio and your smart speaker.
Play Wave 105.
Wave 105.
Hello, morning to you at 6. It's emerged some patients have been waiting more than 10 hours in the A&E departments of Bournemouth and Poole.
Miley Cyrus, Malibu, 6:30. It's Wave 105. Good morning. Should be dry today. Generally cloudy this morning. Maybe the odd sunny spell this afternoon. Windy, highs of 13.
Hello, good morning to you. In the headlines, it's emerged some patients have been waiting more than 10 hours in the A&E departments of Bournemouth and Poole.
And keep up to date by following us on social media. See you Saturday.
On digital radio,
FM,
and on your smart speaker.
This is Fife's Kingdom FM.
The new leader of a trade union body is calling for an urgent meeting with the Prime Minister to try and break the deadlocked industrial disputes across the country.
Being for the strike.
I was.
And whatever they were striking for.
Whatever it is you guys want, I'm 100% behind. As long as it means I get a day off.
Excellent. Right, on the way, we have your Fact of the Day and your sports news after your news headlines.
The new head of the TUC has called for an urgent meeting with the PM to try to sort out public sector strikes.
Across Aberdeen and North East Scotland.
On FM, digital radio and online.
This is Original 106.
The new leader of a trade union body is calling for an urgent meeting with the Prime Minister to try and break the deadlocked industrial disputes across the country.
Right. Don't quote me on it.
Right, OK.
Highs of 8 degrees. Traffic and travel news on the way after the latest news.
The new head of the TUC has called for an urgent meeting with the PM to try to sort out public sector strikes.
Should stay mostly dry today, but it will be windy with some decent spells of sunshine too.
On FM, on digital radio, and on your smart speaker. This is Chester's D Radio.
All pupils in England could soon be made to study some form of maths until the age of 18.
Online and on DAB digital radio.
This is Love 80s Liverpool.
Prime Minister is to lay out plans to ensure all English school pupils study some form of maths until the age of 18.
Temperature-wise, we've got highs around Wilmslow of 12 Celsius a little later this afternoon.
On FM, online and on your smart speaker, this is Cheshire's Silk 106.9.
All pupils in England could soon be made to study some form of maths until the age of 18.
Muller Lite. Find your flavour today.
On your radio.
On Global Player.
And on your smart speaker.
Play Capital.
This is Capital.
From Global's newsroom at 5, in a major speech, the Prime Minister's promised to halve inflation, grow the economy and reduce national debt.
From the National Lottery. Your numbers make amazing happen. Play on the app. Prize may be capped. Account terms, rules, procedures and game-specific rules apply. Players must be 18 or over.
Ar eich radio, ar Global Player, a...
Play Capital.
Dyma Capital.
O stafell ymwyddion Global am dri, mae'r prif weinidog Rishi Sunak wedi cyhoeddi ei blaenoriaethau am y flwyddyn newydd. Mae o'n dweud ei fod o eisiau haneru chwyddiant i wella'r cost o fyw.
Lloyds Bank, by your side. There is a £10 monthly fee for maintaining the account and benefits are provided by selected third parties. Exclusions apply.
On your radio.
On Global Player.
And on your smart speaker.
Play Capital Extra.
This is
Extra. Capital Extra.
From Global's newsroom at 7, a man from West London has been killed at a guest house in Jamaica.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On your radio.
On Global Player.
And on your smart speaker. Play Classic FM.
This is Classic FM.
From Global's newsroom at 7 o'clock, the Prime Minister will try to set the political agenda later when he reveals plans for all pupils in England to study some form of maths until the age of 18.
Email me your connection to classicfm.com. Right now, 7.30, headlines from Dominic Ellis.
Rishi Sunak will try to set the political agenda later when he reveals plans for all pupils in England to study some form of maths until the age of 18.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On digital radio, on Global Player, on your smart speaker.
Play Gold.
Playing the greatest hits of all time.
This is Gold.
News.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Holly Harris. The new General Secretary of the TUC has written to the Prime Minister to ask him to reopen pay negotiations with unions and start a mature conversation.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On your radio, on Global Player and on your smart speaker.
Play Heart.
This is Heart. 7 o'clock, here's the latest.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Alice Young. Rishi Sunak is looking at plans to make all students in England study maths until they're 18.
X Heart's 2023 January jackpot continues at 8 o'clock this morning. The time now is 7.30. Here's the latest.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Alice Young. Rishi Sunak says he wants all students in England to study some kind of maths until they're 18.
Visit them online for great priced cars and vans under 4 years old and less than 30,000 miles.
On your radio, on Global Player and on your smart speaker.
Play Heart.
This is Scotland's Heart. It's 5 o'clock. Here's the latest.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Becky Clark. Prime Minister Rishi Sunak has been setting out his priorities for the new year.
On your radio, on Global Player, and on your smart speaker.
Play Heart 70s.
This is Heart 70s.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Maire Thomas. Rishi Sunak is looking at plans to make all students in England study maths until they're 18.
On your radio, on Global Player, and on your smart speaker.
Play Heart 80s.
This is Heart 80s.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Maire Thomas. Rishi Sunak is looking at plans to make all students in England study maths until they're 18.
On your radio, on Global Player and on your smart speaker.
Play Heart 90s.
This is Heart 90s.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Maire Thomas. Rishi Sunak is looking at plans to make all students in England study maths until they're 18.
On your radio, on Global Player and on your smart speaker.
Play Heart Noughties.
This is Heart Noughties.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Maer Thomas. Rishi Sunak is looking at plans to make all students in England study maths until they're 18.
Welcome along to Hard Dance Breakfast. It's Toby here. Right, School Run Ravers is about to get going with Shakedown and Doolally straight from the heart. But first, Maya's got the latest. It's 8 o'clock.
On your radio, on Global Player and on your smart speaker.
Play Hard Dance.
This is Hard Dance.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Maer Thomas. Students across England could soon be made to study maths until they're 18.
It's not harm, it's a lack of opportunity.
I've done my best, I have to go to the news now.
Putting the question of cotton wool is reducing opportunity.
Yeah, okay. Thanks, I think. And there it is. I don't know whether Beth would describe herself as a follower or a disciple of Sir Desmond Swain, but this bizarre psychological stroke... pseudo-intellectual desire to believe that the best advice we have, you look at the numbers, as the earlier caller who's off to Hong Kong referred to, you look at the simple facts, and even if they were wrong, I still wouldn't understand why you wouldn't wear one. If all of the people qualified to offer up such advice are saying, look, it's a good idea, where does this desire to believe that it isn't a good idea come from? And unfortunately, I'm sure it's my fault, I'm no closer to understanding that after the last conversation than I was an hour ago. I blame Desmond Swain.
On your radio, on Global Player, and...
Play LBC.
Leading Britain's conversation, this is LBC.
From Global's newsroom... As Rishi Sunak prepares to set out his priorities in his first speech of 2023, he is under increasing pressure from unions.
If you want to put a question to the General Secretary of the RMT, the number you need is 0345 6060973. Meanwhile, Holly Harris is here with your headlines.
The General Secretary of the RMT says the government is blocking the sensible negotiation that could lead to a deal and avoid more rail strikes.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On your radio, on Global Player, and...
Play LBC News.
Where the news never stops. This is LBC News.
From Global's newsroom, it is 6 o'clock on Wednesday, the 4th of January. I'm Lisa Aziz. Good morning. Here's the latest. The Health Secretary, Steve Barclay, has defended his handling of the NHS, saying there have been particular pressures over Christmas. The Prime Minister is considering plans for all children to study some form of maths until they turn 18. It's expected to form part of Rishi Sunak's first speech of the year later, setting out his priorities for the 12 months ahead. The new head of the TUC has called for an urgent meeting with the Prime Minister to try to break the deadlock on strikes. Rail workers are continuing their first 48-hour strike of this week with very few trains running. And latest research suggests around a third of us are planning to find a new job this year.
LBC News. Weather.
The brisk westerly winds are still with us throughout the day, so 10 to 13 degrees for most areas despite showery bands of rain in the north. Often cloudy with some sunny breaks here and there. I'm back in 15 minutes.
LBC News. Travel.
LBC Travel, I'm Joanne Webb. It's day two of the train strike, which means most train services are suspended until after 7.30 this morning. There's also no London Overground trains until after then, and the Elizabeth line isn't running to and from Paddington, and also no service between Liverpool Street and Shenfield. But even after 7.30 this morning, there'll be a reduced service across all the networks, and part of the networks will be completely suspended. Now, on the roads, there's problems with the M48 Severn Bridge. It's closed in both directions because of the strong winds. Also because of the strong winds, there's a 30 miles per hour speed restriction on the Humber Bridge. And in Essex, the A12 is closed southbound at junction 17 at Howe Green after an accident.
This is LBC News.
Well, the Health Secretary has blamed flu, COVID and strep A for the recent NHS pressures.
Get assessed and directed to the right place for you in as little as 90 seconds. Use NHS 111 online.
The news in 20 minutes. Every 20 minutes. 24 hours a day. Where the news never stops. This is LBC News.
From Global's newsroom, 20 minutes after midday, this is Martin Stanford. Good afternoon to you. Here are the latest news headlines. A group representing doctors is calling for an emergency meeting about the NHS with Rishi Sunak.
Kia.
Movement that inspires.
T's and C's apply. Petrol models only. Kia Finance ends 28th of February.
News, sport, travel, weather. In 20 minutes. Every 20 minutes. Where the news never stops. This is LBC News.
From Global's newsroom, it's 3:39. I'm Jim Diamond. Good afternoon. Rishi Sunak's pledged to bring down NHS waiting lists and halve inflation as part of his five priorities for 2023.
Book now with Virgin Atlantic. See the world differently.
On your radio, on Global Player, and on your smart speaker.
Play Radio X.
This is Radio X News.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Dominic Ellis. The Prime Minister will try to set the political agenda for the year later as the government remains under pressure over the NHS and the ongoing strike action.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On your radio,
on Global Player,
and on your smart speaker.
Play smooth.
This is Smooth Radio.
From Global's newsroom, I'm Holly Harris. The new General Secretary of the TUC has written to the Prime Minister to ask him to reopen pay negotiations with unions and start a mature conversation.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On your radio.
On Global Player.
And on your smart speaker.
Play smooth.
This is Smooth Radio.
From Global's newsroom at 7, many households suffered a challenging Christmas as food inflation hit a record high in December.
Don't wombat it, meerkat it with Compare the Market.
Simples!
On 106 FM, DAB and online, this is Jack FM News.
Joe here with your top stories. The Prime Minister says his new mission is to get all pupils in England studying maths in some form until they're 18.
Don't wombat it, meerkat it with Compare the Market.
Simples!
On digital radio and smart speakers.
This is Jack 2 Hits.
Hi, Joe here with your top stories. And the Prime Minister says his new mission is to get all pupils in England studying maths in some form until they're 18.
Don't wombat it, meerkat it with Compare the Market.
Simples.
On 107.9 FM, digital radio and smart speakers.
Jack 3 and 2.
Hi, Joe here with your top stories. And the Prime Minister says his new mission is to get all pupils in England studying maths in some form until they're 18.
London on 1450 AM and DAB, smart speaker, mobile app, and LaikaRadio.com.
This is Laika Radio.
From the Sky News Centre at 7, Rishi Sunak says he wants all pupils in England to study maths until they're 18.
Our lowest prices are guaranteed only when you book directly through travelup.com or call 0207 580 5000.
Laika Radio.
60 second headlines.
Looking at your top headlines for now then, the Prime Minister is looking at plans to ensure all pupils in England study from the form, some form of maths until the age of 18.
Across London on 10:35 AM, DAB, smart speaker and LaikaGold.com. This is Laika Gold.
From the Sky News Centre at 7, Rishi Sunak says he wants all pupils in England to study maths until they're 18.
To guarantee your rent, 52 weeks through the year, choose Upwood.
Time.
Time.
On the hour. With the news that matters.
Time.
Time 107.5.
From the Sky News Centre at 7, Rishi Sunak says he wants all pupils in England to study maths until they're 18.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
Across Wales on DAB Digital Radio.
On your smart speaker.
And online at dragonradio.wales.
Dragonradio.wales.
This is Dragon Radio.
The new boss of the TUC wants an urgent meeting with Rishi Sunak to break the deadlock strikes across the country.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On your smart speaker, on the Nation Player app, and on your radio across the UK, this is Easy Radio.
The new boss of the TUC wants an urgent meeting with Rishi Sunak to break the deadlock strikes across the country.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On your smart speaker, on the Nation Player app, and on your radio.
Across the UK.
This is Nation Radio.
The new boss of the TUC wants an urgent meeting with Rishi Sunak to break the deadlock strikes across the country.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On digital radio.
Online.
102.5 FM.
And on your smart speaker. This is your
Radio Pembrokeshire.
The new boss of the TUC wants an urgent meeting with Rishi Sunak to break the deadlock strikes across the country.
The Rig, streaming on Prime Video, January 6th.
On FM.
On your phone.
And on your smart speaker.
With the latest news for Wearside and County Durham.
This is Sun FM.
The new boss of the TUC wants an urgent meeting with Rishi Sunak to break the deadlock strikes across the country.
White Fibre. Because we care.
On FM, online and on your smart speaker. This is Isle of Wight Radio.
Isle of Wight Radio News at 8. All pupils in England will study maths until they're 18 under a new plan from Rishi Sunak.
Howdy, boys. With your chaps on.
Yeah.
Oh, it's 8:30 right now. On FM, online and on your smart speaker, the very latest news and sports headlines. Wednesday, 4th of January, it's Jamie.
Thanks, Paul. Rishi Sunak's announcing plans to make it compulsory for pupils in England to study maths until they're 18.
Read it online today at sussexliving.com.
Across Sussex on DAB, FM, online and here.
Play More Radio.
This is More Radio.
From the More Radio News Centre. The Prime Minister wants all pupils in England to study some form of maths until the age of 18.
OK.
Yeah.
I'm sure my husband's well up for seeing Dua Lipa.
Oh, he and I will go. We'll leave you at home. Time for some news headlines. Back on the show with TLC. We're going to play Waterfalls in just a second. It's got some Jack Jones as well on the playlist next.
The Prime Minister wants all pupils in England to study some form of maths until the age of 18.
We'll keep you up to date.
More. Across Sussex, on DAB, online and on your smart speaker, this is More Radio Retro.
From the More Radio News Centre. The Prime Minister wants all pupils in England to study some form of maths until the age of 18.
FA Cup Live on TalkSport with Carling, the official beer partner of the Emirates FA Cup. 18 plus, please drink responsibly.
On the app, on DAB, on 1089, 1053 medium wave, and on your smart speaker, TalkSport.
Good morning to you and welcome along. This is TalkSport Breakfast this Thursday morning. TalkSport is your home of the FA Cup this weekend with 9 live commentaries across the network, and it all kicks off with live and exclusive coverage of Manchester United versus Everton tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Nick Ellaby has your sport. First with your news, Jenny Barsby.
Natalie, thank you. Good morning. Prince Harry alleges he was attacked by his older brother.
And Antonio Conte just as pleased for Sonny as he is for record chaser Kane.
TalkSport.
Prince Harry is alleging his brother William physically attacked him over his marriage to Meghan Markle.
At Toolstation, tools and more for any task. Sale on Sunday, 15th of January, while stocks last.
Very good morning to you and welcome along. This is TalkSport Breakfast this Thursday morning. TalkSport is your home of the FA Cup this weekend with 9 live commentaries across the network, and it all kicks off with live and exclusive coverage of Manchester United versus Everton tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. Nick Ellaby has your sport. First with your news, Jenny Barsby.
Prince Harry reportedly claims he was physically attacked by his brother William during a row about his marriage to Meghan Markle.
IKEA. The wonderful everyday.
Discuss, debate, deliver.
You have a laugh, ain't ya?
Talk Radio, the home of common sense.
On TV, on radio, and on your smartphone. This is Talk TV. Talk TV News at 7.
Good morning, I'm Zora Suleiman. The royal family has been rocked by more shock revelations as Prince Harry claims he was physically attacked by his brother William during a row over his marriage to Meghan.
Trisha Goddard in the afternoon, Saturday and Sundays from 1 on Talk Radio and Talk TV.
This is Talk TV News.
Good morning, I'm Zora Suleiman. The royal family has been rocked by more shock revelations as Prince Harry claims he was physically attacked by his brother William during a row over his marriage to Meghan.
On this day in 1757, wait for it, Robert François Damien attempted to assassinate the French king Louis XV. Damien was a domestic servant and his motives were unclear. He was burnt alive after hours of appalling torture. And I'm going to warn you, which included molten lead, boiling oil and dismemberment. Casanova witnessed it and was horrified. And we're going to hear more about that. I'm giving you a very long warning just before 10.
I remember reading that. And there's the guy, when he walks up, the guard says to him, "You're going to have a tough day."
Oh, God.
It's like, that turned out to be true. So we are going to try and do some cheery stuff.
We are.
We've also got the William and Harry leak that's come out as well, which is entertaining or sad.
Big news for dog balls.
It's a big news for dog balls. There's lots more to come. Keep your thoughts coming in. 87222. Start your message with the word Times. Or you can tweet us at Times Radio.
Across the UK, on DAB, online and on your smart speaker. This is Times Radio. Know your times.
Good morning, it is 7 o'clock. This is Stig Abel and Asmamir with Times Radio Breakfast.
The headlines this morning, a leak of Prince Harry's book says his brother William physically attacked him and the Labour leader Keir Starmer will give his pitch to fix the country.
Ahead, we'll compare Keir and Rishi's plans for the country and ask which will get your vote. And we'll catch up with Royal Correspondent Rupert Bell for his take on the Prince's punch-up.
It's Thursday the 5th of January.
This is Times Radio.
First, the news, Cara Bentley.
Thanks, Asma. Good morning. Prince Harry has claimed in his new book that his brother knocked him to the floor in an argument about his wife, Meghan.
Now, our royal correspondent, Rupert Bell, is going to take us shortly through the latest revelations from Prince Harry's memoir. If you haven't heard yet, they involve a dog bowl. Before that, and if that doesn't get you gripped, I don't know what will, quite frankly. We're going to get the news before that, of course, at 7.32 with Cara Bentley.
Across the UK, on DAB, online and on your smart speaker. This is Times Radio.
Asma, good morning. Details are seemingly being leaked from Prince Harry's new book, out next week, including his claim that the Prince and Princess of Wales encouraged him to wear a Nazi uniform to a party in 2005.
41% of people want a higher salary. That is to do with the cost of living crisis. You know, that is, whilst people have jobs for many reasons, ultimately it is what they want, is they do it for money.
Don't we all, Jimmy? Don't we all? That's Jimmy McLaughlin from the Jimmy's Jobs of the Future podcast talking about some fascinating data. More than 4 in 10 Britons likely to change their jobs this year. Are you among them? Why not text us? Text Times to 87222 or email matt@times.radio. Really interesting discussion there with Jimmy McLaughlin from the Jimmy's Jobs of the Future podcast, former number 10 advisor. Don't go anywhere. The midday update is next. You're listening to Patrick McGuire here on Times Radio.
Times Radio.
The Midday Update. Your indispensable half-hour bulletin from the Times and the Sunday Times newsroom.
It's 12 o'clock. I'm Patrick McGuire and this is Times Radio's Midday Update, bringing you everything you need to know about what's going on in Britain and beyond this lunchtime. In this half hour, we'll analyse this morning's speech from the Labour leader, Sir Keir Starmer. We'll find out what's moving in the Times newsroom from Jeremy Griffin. And a leak from Prince Harry's new memoir has alleged he was attacked by his brother, the Prince of Wales. But first, let's get the headlines from Cara Bentley.
Thanks, Patrick. Good afternoon. Sir Keir Starmer's resurrected the Brexit campaign slogan, "Take Back Control," saying a government led by him would take back control.
Switch to our keypad 32% discounted tariff for a 12-month fixed term. See website for T's and C's.
Online, on FM, on DAB, and on your smart speaker. Northern Ireland's best mix. This is U105.
Good morning, I'm Colin O'Carroll. Politicians here will host a silent vigil in memory of murder victim Natalie McNally at Stormont later today.
Find the opportunity that fits you at getconnected.info and join us at Connected Health for a resolution we know you'll be happy to keep.
News, online, on FM, on DAB and on your smart speaker. Northern Ireland's best mix, U105.
Just gone 7:30 with the headlines this morning. Here's Colin.
Good morning. Police have seized £180,000 worth of drugs in East Belfast.
A great treat. Well, enjoy yourself. Happy birthday. Many happy returns. And now the time is 7 o'clock. So it is time to join Rachel Horn with the news.
Tom Allen on the Chris Evans Breakfast Show with Sky VIP. The treatment you deserve. On DAB Digital Radio, on the app and on your smart speaker. This is Virgin Radio. News.
I'm Rachel Horn. Our top stories this morning. Rail passengers will face a third consecutive day of travel disruption, the latest because of a strike by members of the train drivers union, ASLEF.
The Duke of Sussex has given a number of interviews ahead of the publication of his book Spare tomorrow.
Or see all our offers online at dynamicfireworks.co.uk.
Live from the City of Colchester, across Essex on DAB Digital Radio, online and on your smart speaker, this is Actual Radio.
Ministers are holding a series of meetings with union leaders as they try to prevent future strikes over pay in the NHS, in classrooms and on the railways.
If you bought a timeshare after 5th of January 1999, text TIME to 78900 to find out more.
From Radio News Hub, I'm Andy Hoyle. Ministers are holding a series of meetings with union leaders as they try to prevent future strikes over pay in the NHS, in classrooms and on the railways.
Asian Sound Radio, Network News, the world's local station. Broadcasting live on DAB across the Northwest and West Yorkshire. Current affairs, international, national and local news on the hour, every hour.
From the Sky News Centre at 10, Prince Harry says he's still not speaking to his brother William or to his father the King, but he's insisted he doesn't intend to harm either of them.
On DAB,
online
and on your mobile.
This is AWNSR
News.
Tomorrow marks the release of the much-anticipated tell-all book from Prince Harry. He's been giving interviews and claims and revelations have also been leaked.
Search for us online for free, friendly advice wherever you are in the county.
In North West Wales, from Colwyn Bay.
Sir Keir Starmer says a future Labour government will not spend their way out of the mess inherited from the Conservatives.
Call Castle on 841314.
It's less hassle when you buy from Castle.
Castle Windows.
From Cockerham to Carnforth, from Foughton to Millhead.
Real local radio for North Lancashire.
We're local too.
This is Beyond Radio News.
From the Sky News Centre at 4, Prince Harry has admitted for the first time that he took cocaine when he was 17.
On air, online, on the app,
on FM,
and DAB Plus throughout the UK. This is BFBS, the Forces Station.
fierce Russian assault on Bakhmut in Ukraine.
Their soldiers openly advance under fire, even if they're littering the ground with their bodies.
MOD says it is ready to lead NATO task force next year.
I think that, you know, the MOD, having made this very public, a very clear statement saying there's no truth in this story, we're absolutely ready, we're absolutely committed.
And train drivers on strike.
Seems to have no end to it in sight. It's causing us tremendous problems.
This is Forces News.
With Tim Cooper.
The Ukrainian commander in charge of the defense of the eastern city of Bakhmut says his troops are facing ferocious attacks.
AM.
FM.
Online.
Online. Apps.
तथा स्मार्ट स्पीकर हरुमा सुन्न सकिने.
यो.
यो. BFBS.
गोरखा रेडियो हो.
रूपन्देहीको सिद्धार्थनगरमा साढे घिसारेको फोटो भाइरल भएपछि स्थानीय सरकारको चौतर्फी आलोचना भएको छ।
From the Sky News Centre at 8, Prince Harry's described the Queen Consort as dangerous, claiming Camilla has forged connections in the British press.
Coming up just for you, after the news at midday.
Live on 87.7 FM, on digital and on the bedside radios across Dundee's hospital network. This is Bridge FM News on the hour.
From Feature Story News in London, I'm Ollie Barrett. Brazil's president says rioters who stormed the country's Congress will be punished.
Across the Furness Peninsula, 106.3. And Ulverston, 107.3. From the heart of Furness, on FM, online and on your smart speaker, this is Can Do FM.
From the Sky News Centre at 7, Prince Harry's accused members of his family of getting into bed with the devil by forming a close relationship with the press.
Across the UK, online, mobile app, digital platforms, smart speakers and DAB.
With the latest national and international news on the hour, every hour. This is Care Radio.
Despite the leaking of many of its claims, Prince Harry's book Spare is set to be published tomorrow.
Or just start your day with Actimel, packed with vitamin D. It's the little daily habit that's big on immune support. Contains vitamins D and B6, which help support the immune system.
On 103.1 FM, on digital radio, or launch Central FM on your smart speaker.
This is Central FM News.
With the latest at 8, I'm Andrew Baxter. Pupils across the Forth Valley are returning to school today, but there will be disruption this week due to strike action.
Monday on the Central FM break for Shove Space Girls. The school run shuffle is back. That may be a hallelujah moment for many. It's on the way in the next few minutes, plus some Lewis Capaldi after the news and sport with Andrew Baxter.
Children across the Forth Valley go back to school today, but there will be disruption this week.
When you and me, no judgment.
On DAB Digital Radio, across the Fylde Coast, via smart speaker and the Central Radio mobile app.
This is Central Radio News.
With the latest news for Central Radio, I'm Kayleigh Hall. The brave sacrifice of three police officers who died in the Sea of Blackpool will be honoured with a ceremony on the 40th anniversary of the tragedy.
Visit wirememorials.co.uk for inspiration and advice. Wire Memorials. Proud to be local.
Keeping you up to date for Blackpool Wire and Fylde.
This is Coastal Radio DAB.
This is your local news for Coastal Radio DAB. The draw for the fourth round of the FA Cup has been made, and Blackpool now know they'll go to Southampton at the end of the month.
live on digital radio, colorfulradio.com, and apps. This is Colorful Radio.
The funeral mass for former Pope Benedict XVI will begin shortly.
On your radio, on your phone, and
play Country Line Radio.
This is the UK's country station. Country Line Radio, 60-second headlines.
Ministers are to hold a series of meetings today with union leaders. They're trying to prevent future strikes over pay in the NHS, in classrooms and on the railways.
Breakfast headlines.
From Radio News Hub, I'm Andy Hoyle. Ministers are holding a series of meetings with union leaders as they try to prevent future strikes over pay in the NHS, in classrooms and on the railways.
On our app, on your smart speaker and on DAB digital radio, this is Durham on Air News.
Police say the body found in an Essex pond has been confirmed as 59-year-old Philip Lewis.
It's almost 4 o'clock on Fix Radio. Time flies, especially when you remember that Panasonic have been heating and cooling your home since 1978.
On air, online, on your phone and on site. This is Fix Radio.
From the Sky News Centre at 4, Prince Harry has admitted for the first time that he took cocaine when he was 17.
It's time to visit Research Garage Hinckley. The big sale is on and runs throughout January with both new and used stock prices reduced.
On 107.9 FM in Hinckley and Nuneaton. Online.
On your smart speaker.
And on the FOSS 107 app. We are FOSS 107.
From the Sky News Centre at 8, Prince Harry's described the Queen consort as dangerous, claiming Camilla has forged connections in the British press.
Visit gov.uk/saveenergy for all of our energy saving tips.
On 107 FM in Loughborough and Charnwood. Online.
On your smart speaker.
And on the FOSS 107 app. We are FOSS 107.
From the Sky News Centre at 8, Prince Harry's described the Queen consort as dangerous, claiming Camilla has forged connections in the British press.
Survey said answer on the way then in the next 10 minutes. Only 9 days we are into the new year, yet about 20%, a fifth then, of all people admit they have already done this at least once. What is it they've done?
FOSS 107 News.
Now the latest for Hinckley and Nuneaton. Leicestershire Police made 173 arrests during their recent winter drink and drug driving campaign.
Survey said answer on the way then in the next 10 minutes. Only 9 days we are into the new year, yet about 20%, a fifth then, of all people admit they have already done this at least once. What is it they've done?
FOSS 107 News.
Now the headlines for Loughborough and Charnwood. Leicestershire Police made 173 arrests during their recent winter drink and drug driving campaign.
Click airtransat.co.uk to book. Selected dates and cities. Limited availability. Conditions apply.
On your radio. On your phone. And smart speaker.
Play Gaydio. This is Gaydio.
With the latest, I'm Millie Mountford. Labour's leader says his party won't use a big chequebook to fix the country's problems if it were to win the next election.
See what you're eligible for at gov.uk/help for households.
It's 12 o'clock. This is GB News Live, and here's what's coming up for you this afternoon. Prince Harry launched a broadside at the King, the Queen Consort, his brother and other royals in a furious ITV interview in which he defended his memoir. In the interview, he made a serious claim, saying he was angry that the royal family didn't defend Meghan in the wake of alleged racist treatment from the media. Rishi Sunak's government is said to be considering a one-off payment for nurses and ambulance workers to end strikes causing major disruption to the NHS. The Prime Minister sparked what they're calling a chink of optimism about a possible pay boost for health workers after he signalled a willingness to address higher pay demands for the first time. And thousands of supporters of Brazil's ousted former president, Jair Bolsonaro, stormed the country's Congress, Supreme Court and presidential offices yesterday to protest against what they claim was a stolen election. It's been dubbed as the culmination of years of conspiracy theories advanced by Mr. Bolsonaro and his allies. And also today, the first ever orbital space launch from British soil is getting ready to blast off. The mission today will see a jumbo jet release a rocket over the Atlantic to take 9 tiny satellites into orbit. Newquay Airport in Cornwall is the starting point for the operation just before midnight tonight. Now, if you've got a view on that or anything else that you want to talk about today, I'd love to hear from you. GBviews@gbnews.uk. Before all of that, though, let's get the latest news headlines with Tamsin.
Stephen, thank you. Good afternoon from the GB Newsroom. It's 2 minutes past 12. Prince Harry has made further claims against the royal family in a series of interviews to promote his memoir Spare, coming out tomorrow.
We're also looking ahead to the business energy support expected to be announced this afternoon. First, though, Tamsin's got your news update.
Stephen, thank you. It's 12:33. Here's the latest from the GB Newsroom. Prince Harry has made further claims against the royal family in a series of interviews to promote his memoir Spare. Baby, I know you always get a good feel with me.
On DAB, smart speaker, phone and online, this is Suffolk's Gen X Radio.
Tomorrow marks the release of the much-anticipated tell-all book from Prince Harry.
We're going to head over to Andy Hoyle in the newsroom for the latest and the headlines.
Tomorrow marks the release of the much-anticipated tell-all book from Prince Harry.
Got some KSI, I'm Tom Grennan. Madonna coming up after the latest news headlines now. And it is 7 o'clock.
Online and across Oxfordshire on DAB Digital Radio. This is Get Radio News.
Ministers are holding a series of meetings with union leaders as they try to prevent future strikes over pay in the NHS, in classrooms and on the railways.
Take a replay and then do it then? Oh, it'd be amazing. Really looking forward to that. We've got some showbiz coming up too. We've got some Meghan Trainor after the latest news headlines now.
Ministers are holding a series of meetings with union leaders as they try to prevent future strikes over pay in the NHS.
At Affinity Stirling Mills in Tillicoultrie. See stirlingmills.com for more.
On DAB, online and on your smart speaker, just say, launch Go Radio. This is Go Radio News.
Good afternoon, it's 2 o'clock, I'm Peter Quinn. Sir Keir Starmer has outlined what he'd do as a Prime Minister, insisting a Labour government wouldn't spend its way out of what he's described as a Tory mess.
Favourite city in the world? I'm going to tell you why I'm asking that when we come back straight after the 5 o'clock news and three players of this week's Just Say Yes Challenge.
LGBTQ plus station.
Live on digital radio and around the world online. This is Gorgeous.
Gorgeous. News.
From the Sky News Centre at 5, Prince Harry's admitted he took cocaine when he was a teenager.
Across Manchester, Cheshire and the North West.
Playing the songs that make you smile.
This is Happy Radio.
Prince Harry's given a number of interviews and claims and excerpts from his book are continuing to be leaked. I skip a heartbeat for
you.
97.5 FM, online at heartland.scot, and on your smart speaker. This is Heartland FM News.
Prince Harry's given a number of interviews and claims and excerpts from his book are continuing to be leaked. It's due to be released tomorrow.
From across the Western Isles to your radio, this is Isles FM News.
Good afternoon, I'm Janet Ramsey. Unlaunders Creative Connections is a series of free creative workshops for adults over the age of 60 in the Western Isles.
Starting your day, The Breakfast Show on Geo Radio. This is Geo Radio with the latest news.
Despite the leaking of many of its claims, Prince Harry's book Spare is set to be published tomorrow.
Online at kl1radio.co.uk. Smart device, tune in, free mobile app, and on DAB digital radio. This is West Norfolk's KL1 Radio.
Police say the body found in an Essex pond has been confirmed as 59-year-old Philip Lewis.
There's a 20-minute teaser coming up as well. We're back to work for it, but would you wear this at work? We'll find out what it is very soon. Right now on DAB Digital Radio across West Norfolk, this is KL1 Radio at 5:30. Here's your latest local headlines.
KL1 Radio, local headlines.
With the latest news headlines for King's Lynn and West Norfolk, I'm Kayleigh Hall. A woman has vowed to chain herself to a bus in protest at a vital service being cut.
Travel.
With onemaidstone.com. Supporting Kent's county town. Shop, dine and entertain in Maidstone.
On FM.
DAB.
Smart speaker.
And your phone.
From KM Media Group.
This is KM FM News.
Now with the latest news for Kent. At 7 o'clock, here's Lucy Hickmarks.
Harry's accused members of his family of being complicit in the suffering endured by his wife because of their close relationships with the tabloid press.
And on the M2 westbound, one lane is closed due to an earlier accident, oil spillage from Junction 3 Chatham through to Junction 2 Rochester. Now with the latest news for Kent at 7:30, here's Lucy Hickmott.
He's accused members of his family of being complicit in the suffering endured by his wife Meghan.
This is the Light Music Station, Light Radio News.
Despite the leaking of many of its claims, Prince Harry's book Spare is set to be published tomorrow.
On air, online, on your smart speaker and on your mobile. This is Liverpool Live News.
Despite the leaking of many of its claims, Prince Harry's book Spare is set to be published tomorrow.
Coming up, brand new week of Best of the Best. It's 8 week. Hopefully doing better than last week.
Your first and only choice for Mansfield News and Sports.
From the Sky News Centre at 7, Prince Harry's accused members of his family of getting into bed with the devil by forming a close relationship with the press.
7 till 9 every Friday, Brandon Block and Ricky Morrison, the musical emporium on my soul.
Yes, yes, yeah.
From the My Soul Network Centre.
Across town, on DAB Radio and online. This is My Soul News.
A coroner has described shooting victim Ellie Edwards as a beautiful young woman as she opened an inquest into her death.
Tomorrow, apparently, highs are 13 as well. It's nearly 9 o'clock now.
Live from the world's greatest new city.
On FM, on digital radio, on your smart speaker and on the new MKFM app.
This is MKFM.
At 9, Prince Harry's accused members of the royal family of getting in bed with the devil over their links with the press.
The high around 9 degrees Celsius.
This is News Radio UK.
Despite the leaking of many of its claims, Prince Harry's book Spare is set to be published tomorrow.
On digital radio, on the app, online, and on your smart speaker.
The greatest hits for Glasgow and the West.
Clyde 2.
Garage owners in Glasgow are telling Clyde News they're having a busy winter fixing cars damaged by potholes.
Whitney Houston and Kenny G for the love of you on Panacea.
Panacea.
Right, we have our news and weather update for 9 o'clock coming your way now. I've got some great soul tracks to play from Starpoint and Change all coming up next. Stay there.
OTB.
On the app.
Online.
And on your smart speaker.
Playing soul, funk and groove.
This is Panacea.
Panacea News.
Tomorrow marks the release of the much-anticipated tell-all book from Prince Harry.
How short is your break? Vaheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji Ki Fateh. Vaheguru,
On AM, TV, digital radio and online, this is Panjab Radio. News on the hour.
From the Sky News Centre at 9, Prince Harry's accused members of the royal family of getting in bed with the devil over their links with the press.
Discover our beautiful Be Still and Know wallpaper for your computer, tablet or mobile at premier.org.uk and click free resources. Finally, something good in your inbox.
On air, online and on digital, this is Premier Christian Radio.
Good afternoon, I'm Kelly Valencia. NHS staff will strike again as planned this month after a meeting between union bosses and the health secretary broke down earlier.
Faith in their future. Visit premiernextgen.com.
On mobile, online and on digital radio across the UK, this is Premier Praise.
Good afternoon, I'm Kelly Valencia with your latest headlines. NHS staff will strike again as planned this month after a meeting between union bosses and the health secretary broke down earlier.
Or just start your day with Actimel, packed with vitamin D. It's the little daily habit that's big on immune support. Contains vitamins D and B6, which help support the immune system.
This is Q Radio across Northern Ireland. Q.
At 8 o'clock, I'm Jim McLean. Detectives investigating the death of Natalie McNally have revisited her Lurgan home.
And there's one in particular that I can't quite believe. We'll play that out for you in the next few minutes. Before we do that, let's get some news headlines with Jim. Morning, Jim.
Morning, Declan. Detectives continue to hunt for the killer of Natalie McNally in Lurgan, 3 weeks on from the murder of the 32-year-old mother-to-be.
It's simple. We find jobs for people and people for jobs. Call us today on 01761 235 741 or visit our website simplerecruitmentltd.co.uk.
Online, on your smart speaker and on DAB Digital Radio, a voice for Bath. This is Radio Bath News.
Despite the leaking of many of its claims, Prince Harry's book Spare is set to be published tomorrow.
If you do spot something or you can update me, the number to call is 01702 45 50 60.
On FM, DAB, online, on the Radio Essex app, and here.
Play Radio Essex.
Live from the Icon Building. This is Radio Essex.
At 7, Prince Harry's insisted he has no intention to hurt his father, the King, or brother William, as his ITV interview aired.
This phone confused me. I was discombobulated, I was.
Time now, 7:30.
These are the stories you're waking up to this morning. Prince Harry says it was the British press who accused a member of the royal family of racism following their TV programme with Oprah Winfrey.
It's time to roll on down to Market Carpets, one of the largest roll stockists in the southwest, in Exeter, Exmouth and Tiverton, and online too. On FM and digital radio.
On smart speakers.
And on the Radio X app.
From Devon.
For Devon.
This is Radio X.
I'm Alison Johns. Up to 2,500 people are expected at Cornwall Airport Newquay tonight to watch a first for the UK space industry.
Timberland and One Republic with Apologise.
Kate Bush coming soon. Harry Styles before nine. And your chance to win £1,000 for giving me the correct code to unlock the vault. One Devon River and one single number could win you that grand next. First, half eight, let's get Devon's headlines with Jamie Taylor.
Morning, Mads. It's all eyes on Nuki later as the UK hosts its first ever space launch. A repurposed jumbo jet carrying a rocket containing satellites will launch off from Spaceport Cornwall.
And we are looking at a high of 8 degrees, so it's a little bit cooler than the rest of the week, where we are going back into double figures. And right now, it is currently 6 in Kingston.
Across southwest London and North Surrey, live from Tolworth Tower, this is 107.8 Radio Jackie.
Ministers are meeting union leaders as they look to avoid more strikes from nurses, teachers and rail workers.
Online, on your mobile, on your smart speaker and on DAB digital radio. This is Radio Shields News Update.
Tomorrow marks the release of the much-anticipated tell-all book from Prince Harry.
The Isle of Skye Estate Agency is your local solution. Give us a call on 01478 612 683. Sponsors of today's breakfast show on Radio Skye.
Your latest news from across the UK on Radio Skye.
Well, it's just after 7:30. Let's have a look at those top stories then. There are reports that Prince Harry makes allegations in his new book that his brother William physically attacked him in a row about Meghan.
Check your festive bin collection day at the Your Bins page of our website. Why not make sure your New Year's resolution is to use your weekly food candy collection all year round?
In West Norfolk, fire crews attended an incident on Downham Market High Street yesterday afternoon after a commercial building caught fire.
Tens of thousands of people will attend the funeral mass for former Pope Benedict XVI when it begins shortly.
Not in the news, we're going to take a look at a story not making it into the headlines this morning. And some great tunes from Beyonce, Jennifer Lopez, and also a new one from the 1975.
Now, with the latest national and international news, this is Radio Extra.
Prince Harry has given a number of interviews and claims and excerpts from his book are continuing to be leaked.
On DAB, on smart speakers, online and our free to download app. We are Rotherham and South Yorkshire's local hit music station. RB1 Radio News.
With the latest news for Rotherham and South Yorkshire, I'm Kayleigh Hall. A Rotherham man made £4,000 a month after turning to dealing drugs, but spent most of the proceeds paying off his gambling debts.
RB and the number one, with your name, where you're from, and your message, and send it to 8228. Right, we're on DAB across Rotherham and South Yorkshire. You can ask Alexa to play RB1 Radio. We're on your smart speakers, we're online. You can download the free app to your smartphones and tablets and take us wherever you go. Just coming up to 28 minutes past seven, let's get the latest news now for Rotherham and South Yorkshire with Kayleigh this morning.
With the latest news headlines for Rotherham and South Yorkshire, I'm Kayleigh Hall. A Rotherham man made £4,000 a month after turning to dealing drugs, but spent most of the proceeds paying off his gambling debts.
Hey, I'm Emery.
Hey, this is Ava Max.
Yo, what's going on? It's Jax Jones.
Hi, we're Little Mix. This is Regency.
Health unions look set to press ahead with their planned walkouts after describing talks with the government today as an insult.
Persistent rain and strong winds move in from the west during the early hours, lows dropping down to around 1 degree.
On DAB, on app, on smart speaker and online. Rewind Radio.
Prince Harry's given a number of interviews and claims and excerpts from his book are continuing to be leaked.
No fighting, no fighting, no fighting,
no fighting. No fighting.
Online at rotherradio.co.uk, on your smart speaker and on DAB digital radio across Rotherham and Sheffield. This is Rother Radio News.
Tens of thousands of people will attend the funeral mass for former Pope Benedict XVI when it begins shortly.
George Ezra and Dance All Over Me, Rother Radio Thursday morning. Great song from Scarlett on an independent love song. But first, let's check out the latest news headlines.
60-second headline news.
Rother Radio.
The funeral mass for former Pope Benedict XVI will begin shortly.
Happy New Year.
Your number one
hit Asian music station
in the Midlands.
Subress Radio.
From the Sky News Centre at 5. Prince Harry's admitted he took cocaine when he was a teenager.
Life begins now. Book today with GoSkydive.com.
DAB Digital Radio, across South Wiltshire and West Hampshire.
And on all your smart devices.
This is Salisbury Radio, the way it is.
Ministers are to hold a series of meetings today with union leaders.
I do find, though, that there's no need for gloating. No one likes a gloater. I shall discuss later on this morning. Got to talk about the masked singer as well. Let's get on today's details with the way it is. For a sunny Monday and 9 degrees and 4 this evening.
It's been revealed the MP for Salisbury, John Glenn, is in the lowest 25% of additional earners in Parliament.
You've just got in the car on the way home and you're thinking, oh, I've had a really stressful day, Simo, play me something just to chill me out and calm me down. All right, I've got Cyndi Lauper and True Colours.
The home of the Sandgrounder Secret Sound. Guess the sound. Win the pounds.
Sandgrounder Radio. News.
The strikes in the NHS are still on after today's talks between trade unions and the government were branded an insult.
On DAB Digital Radio and online at sanskarradio.com. Yeh hai aapka Sanskar Radio.
The Sky News Centre at 6. Prince Harry's admitted in his upcoming memoir that he took cocaine when he was a teenager.
No, I can't sleep until I feel your touch.
SIBC News.
A joint project between Sky News and Tortoise Media has calculated from a number of sources how much extra earnings went to politicians in addition to their base salary.
Music, news and information for Brighton and Hove 24 hours a day. Southdown Radio.
Ahead of its publication tomorrow, members of the public have been sharing their thoughts on Prince Harry's Spare, the much-anticipated tell-all book.
News for Brighton and Hove, 24 hours a day. Sourced from brightonandhovenews.org. Southdown Radio.
Two infant schools and a junior school look likely to have their admission numbers cut.
St Ives, as you head home along Harrison Way, you've got a queue around the A1123. Huntingdon, leaving town on Spittles Way, it is stop-start. And Cambridge, as you come out of town on the A1307, heavier than normal around Addenbrookes.
On your smart speaker. Play Star Radio.
On your mobile.
And on 100.7 FM across Cambridgeshire.
This is Star Radio.
From the Sky News Centre at 5. The Health Secretary says he wants to find common ground in a pay dispute with NHS staff after talks resulted in no cancellation of upcoming strikes.
Broadcasting live, on digital radio and online.
Across your area and truly local.
Bringing you the latest news for Stockport and the world.
This is Strawberry Radio.
All the greatest.
has given a number of interviews. Claims from his book are continuing to be leaked. It's finally due to be released tomorrow.
Shark Tank. Watch tonight, 9 p.m. on Sony TV.
On AM in London and nationwide on DAB. This is Sunrise News.
From the Sky News Centre at 11, the Prime Minister's refusing to say if a new offer's on the table to resolve strike action by nurses in England.
To the Asian community, 24 hours a day, this is Sunrise Radio Yorkshire.
From the Sky News Centre at 4. NHS strikes are to go ahead as planned this month, with one union describing talks with the Health Secretary as bitterly disappointing.
On FM, online and on your smart speaker, this is Sunshine Radio News.
From the Sky News Centre at 3. The footballer Benjamin Mendy says he's delighted after being cleared of sex attacks on four women.
Yeah. On FM, digital radio, online, on your mobile and smart speaker.
This is The Voice.
News.
The strikes in the NHS are still on after today's talks between trade unions and the government were branded an insult.
Visit jitterbugschildcare.co.uk or call to register.
Local radio for Whitby, Scarborough, Filey and Bridlington. On DAB, online and your smart speaker.
This is The Coast.
This is The Coast. I'm Sean Moore. Prince Harry's accused members of the royal family of getting in bed with the devil over their links with the press.
Information, what's on, the mountain weather forecast, the inshore forecast, plus music you know and music you've yet to discover. This is Two Locks Radio and Loughbroom FM.
At 8, Prince Harry says he and Meghan never accused the royal family of racism in their interview with Oprah Winfrey. Motherwell remain the team just above them following a 3-2 defeat to Hibs.
Broadcasting to the Gearloch and Loughhew area on 106 and 106.6 FM, Ullapool on 96.8 FM and 102.2, and online at 2lr.co.uk. This is Two Locks Radio and Loughbroom FM.
Two Locks Radio and Loughbroom FM local news for Monday the 9th of January. Highland schools are expected to be affected by strike action this week.
United Christian Broadcasters. This is UCB One.
UCB One.
Building faith for everyday life.
UCB News at 7 o'clock. I'm David Peake. The funeral of former Pope Benedict takes place in St. Peter's Basilica in Rome later. UCB News headlines at 7:30. I'm David Peake. History will be made later as Pope Francis leads the funeral of his predecessor Benedict, the first time that's happened in hundreds of years.
Online, UCB Player. And DAB. This is UCB 2.
UCB News at 7 o'clock. I'm David Peake. The funeral of former Pope Benedict takes place in St. Peter's Basilica in Rome later. UCB News headlines at 7:30. I'm David Peake. History will be made later as Pope Francis leads the funeral of his predecessor Benedict, the first time that's happened in hundreds of years.
Caremark, the mark of excellent care.
on DAB in Sussex and on Sky Q via the Radio Player app. This is V2 Radio. With the latest for Sussex after the national headlines.
From the Sky News Centre at 4, Prince Harry has admitted for the first time that he took cocaine when he was 17, and sales at Greggs jumped by almost a quarter in 2022. The bakery says discount offers did well and purchases of festive bakes added to a strong end of the year. That's the latest. I'm Kat Swab.
V2 Radio, Sussex News.
A garden described as horrendously overgrown in Eastbourne has landed a homeowner with a £3,000 fine.
Serving Southern Hampshire, West Sussex and the Isle of Wight with the best in music and all you need to know.
On DAB+, digital radio and streaming at victoryonline.co.uk.
This is Victory.
Victory, Portsmouth.
Prince Harry's given a number of interviews ahead of the publication of his book Spare tomorrow.
National News. We are your local radio station.
Waves Radio.
From the Sky News Centre at midday, Rishi Sunak says he won't comment on specifics on possible pay deals for striking public sector workers.
Local news. Local weather. We are your local radio station.
Waves Radio.
The First Minister is urging people to avoid unnecessary trips to hospital as staff deal with more cases of things like flu and strep A.
Wow, Blackpool. This is Neil Sexton at WBPL.
Radio is Blackpool as you are. WBPL. Wow, Blackpool.
Across the File Coast, this is Wow, Blackpool. WBPL.
From Blackpool to the world, this is WBPL News.
Prince Harry's given a number of interviews ahead of the publication of his book Spare tomorrow.
Just ask your smart speaker to play Radio Wyvern from Radio Player. From the top of the Tunnel Hill Tower, on your radio, on the Wyvern app, and on your smart speaker.
Playing Radio Wyvern.
First with the news for Worcestershire, this is Wyvern.
Strikes in the NHS are still on, after today's talks between trade unions and the government were branded an insult.
Worcestershire's hit music station, this is Wyvern. Elton John and Britney Spears right before that. Let's get into news. It's news time. This is Wyvern.
Wyvern News, I'm Sean Moore. The county's hospital trust paid almost £4,500 to one agency, Dr. Schiff, last year.
Search Barclay Card Payments. The payment part is just the start. Offers now available. The approval of your application depends on financial circumstances and borrowing history. T's and C's apply. Free accounting software provided by FreshBooks for selected Barclay Card customers only.
On 106.1 FM, online, on the app, and on your smart speaker. This is XS Manchester.
Another group of health workers are being balloted from today about taking strike action in a row over pay.
In York on 102.8 FM, Selby on 90 FM, smart device, online, our free app, and across North Yorkshire on DAB. Your local station, Y01 Radio.
Former Pope Benedict XVI will be laid to rest this morning as his funeral takes place in the Vatican.
And it's also Jess in Strensel's birthday tomorrow. She won't be listening, though, because she's working shifts. And this is her last early today. That's all right, isn't it? Coming up, the Blues Brothers, Toto, your misheard lyrics for Thursday. Now the news and sport at 7.33.
Latest news headlines for York and the surrounding area. I'm Kayleigh Hall.
York's council tax is set to rise by just under 5% as City of York Council faces unprecedented financial pressures.
You're guaranteed a sensational day out at Wetherby Racecourse, and under 18s go racing for free.
York, Selby, Moulton, Tadcaster.
On digital radio, online, app, and on your smart speaker.
This is York Mix Radio.
Sir Keir Starmer says Labour won't be able to spend our way out of the mess left by the Tories, even though he recognises the need for investment.
With Nichols Tyreman, your local independent estate agent.
Proper local radio on DAB, online, on our app and on your Alexa. This is your Harrogate.
I'm Andy Hoyle. These are your Harrogate headlines. North Yorkshire Police is warning residents to be extra vigilant after a number of reports since Christmas where victims have lost thousands of pounds to a well-known courier fraud scam.
On the day you fell in love, love, love.
Online,
DAB,
mobile
and smart speaker.
This is Zest
News.
Ministers are to hold a series of meetings today with union leaders.
Good morning, this is Zest Breakfast with me, Jeff. As we make it to 7:30, time for the latest news update.
Zest Headlines.
From Radio News Hub, I'm Andy Hoyle. Ministers are holding a series of meetings with union leaders as they try to prevent future strikes over pay in the NHS, in classrooms and on the railways.
Live in Staffordshire or Cheshire.
On air, online, on your mobile and smart speaker. Across Staffordshire and Cheshire, this is Signal 2.
From today, anyone who's been in contact with someone with coronavirus will be asked to self-isolate for 14 days.
Drive time, weekdays from 4.
On C103, on FM, online, and on your phone. This is C103 News.
At 7 o'clock on Wednesday morning, the 4th of January. Good morning, I'm Barry O'Mahony. The Minister for Health, Stephen Donnelly, says overcrowding in Irish hospitals will get worse before it gets better.
Easy Living Interiors, Paula Duff, Eastgate, North Point Business Park and Man Point. Winter sale now on.
This is C103 News.
A GoFundMe appeal on behalf of the family of murdered Brazilian woman Bruna Fonseca, found dead in Cork City on New Year's Day, has surpassed its target.
Online, on DAB, and on the Aspen Wait Radio app. This is Aspen Wait Radio News.
Police say the body found in an Essex pond has been confirmed as 59-year-old Philip Lewis.